Good morning, students. How are you? I hope all are you fine. Okay. Mm-hmm. Welcome to the online class. I will introduce first myself. Okay, na? I am Padma from Macherla KGPV in Guntur district. Okay. Today we'll learn about the SSC first chapter, paper one, first chapter, India Relief Feature. India Relief Feature. India Relief Feature. You know that, children? Our country name is India. Our country name is India. What is relief features meaning? The relief features meaning physical features. Physical features. Physical features. Relief features are physical features. Okay? You know, same meaning, both are meaning is same. Relief features are called physical features. Okay, na? You know, relief features are called physical features. What is India? Where is India location? India location. India location. India location in the globe. On the globe. The equator line is divided into two half of the part. The globe, the equator line is 0 degrees. 0 degrees equator line. The equator line is divided into two part. The upper part is, the upper half is northern hemisphere. Northern hemisphere. Northern hemisphere. The lower half of the part is southern hemisphere. Southern hemisphere. Okay? Where is India? The India located in the northern hemisphere. The India located in northern hemisphere. In the particularly, the India located the northern hemisphere in east. Northern hemisphere in east. Okay? Are you understand, children? In the globe, the equator line is divided into two half of parts. Northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. Where is India? India is located in the northern hemisphere, east side. Okay? Where is the vertically located in the India? What is the longitude and latitude? Latitude and longitude. Latitudinal, extent and longitudinal. Longitudinal. Okay. In the India, where is the longitudinal and latitudinal location? This is model of map. I will draw just now in the India map. This is horizontal line. This is equator line 0 degrees. This is 0 degrees equator line. Now latitude lines are increases. Latitude lines are increases. Now main latitude line is India. The main latitude line is India. 8 degrees 4 minutes. 8 degrees 4 minutes. 8 degrees 4 minutes. I will tell Telugu also, okay? Latitude ni akshamsalu antaru. Ekku nunchi Bharatadeshamlo akshamsalu start avutundante 8 degree la 4 nimshal nunchi start avutundi. 0 degrees akshamsalu nunchi start aithe Bharatadeshamku vachesariki bottom lo vachesariki 8 degree la 4 nimshal nunchi start avutundi. ఇలా స్టార్ట్ అవుతా స్టార్ట్ అవుతా ఈ హారిజంటల్ లైన్స్ ఆర్ ద ఇంక్రీజెస్. దిస్ ఇస్ ట్రాపికల్ ఆఫ్ క్యాన్సర్ 23.5 degrees. దిస్ ఇస్ ట్రాపికల్ ఆఫ్ క్యాన్సర్. ట్రాపికల్ ఆఫ్ క్యాన్సర్ 23.5 degrees. అలా ఇంక్రీజ్ అవుతా అవుతా వచ్చేసరికి ఇక్కడికి వచ్చేసరికి లాస్ట్ టాప్ లో వచ్చేసరికి ఎక్కడి నుంచి ఎక్కడ కంటే 37 degrees इला इंक्रीज अवता उंटुंदी नेक्स्ट वेस्ट टू ईस्ट वीटिनी दीज आर कॉल्ड द वर्टिकल लाइंस दीज आर कॉल्ड द वर्टिकल लाइंस वी वर्टिकल लाइंस द स्टार्ट द हियर 68 डिग्रीज 7 मिनट्स 68 डिग्रीज 7 मिनट्स टू वर्टिकल लाइंस आर कॉल्ड द 97 डिग्रीज 25 मिनट्स का एंड అవుతుంది అరుణాచల్ ప్రదేశ్ హియర్ అరుణాచల్ ప్రదేశ్ 97 డిగ్రీస్ 25 మినిట్స్ తో ఎండ్ అవుతుంది దీస్ ఆర్ కాల్డ్ ద లాటిట్యూడినల్ అండ్ లాంగిట్యూడినల్ ఇప్పుడు ఇండియా వేర్ ఇస్ ద ఇండియన్ లొకేషన్ ఇండియా లొకేషన్ ఇన్ లాటిట్యూడినల్ లైన్స్ 8 డిగ్రీస్ 4 మినిట్స్ టు 68 మినిట్స్ 7 డిగ్రీస్ అండ్ లాంగిట్యూడినల్ సారీ హియర్ లాటిట్యూడినల్ 8 డిగ్రీస్ 4 మినిట్స్ టు 37 డిగ్రీస్ 6 మినిట్స్ is latitudinal and longitudinal 68 degrees 7 minutes to 97 degrees 25 minutes these are called the latitudinal and longitudinal lines okay na arthamainda students inka next aye asalu next IST you know IST indian standard time IST indian standard time 82 degrees 30 minutes. IST means here. Okay. Here north to south. North to south. North to south distance is 3,214 kilometers. North to south, north to south distance 3,214 and west to east how much 2,933 kilometers south to north distance 3,214 kilometers west to east 2,933 kilometers here 82.5 degrees in this is called IST indian standard time indian standard time what is the time difference between the arunachal pradesh and gujarat arunachal pradesh and gujarat arunachal pradesh here morning at 5 am here gujarat 7 am the first sun rises in the morning arunachal pradesh 5 am and gujarat 7 am plus 5:30 plus 5:30 hours before in india gmt gmt greenwich mean time greenwich mean time this is called the this is faster than london This is passed on London. Here, the one longitude line is passed away. The cross the 4 minutes. What records are you doing? Maro records are you data dani ki 4 minutes samayam padhuni. Ikka choose na tete. Ikna 37 degrees here. 37 degrees 6 minutes to. 37 minutes 6 degrees to sorry cutta mamani
start
gmt gmt line is greenwich median time pass away from london oka rekansam nunchi inko rekansam ki daatadaniki 4 nimshala samayam padutundi ikkada ela 2 gantala time padutundi arunachal pradesh lo udayam 5 gantala time undi the sun rises in the early morning arunachal pradesh 5 am to gujarat here 7 am what is the time difference between arunachal pradesh and gujarat here 68 degrees 7 minutes to 97 degrees 25 difference between 30 longitudinal lines difference 30 longitudinal lines, 68, 69, 70, 80, 90, 70 degrees to 25 minutes. Difference 30 minutes. Each one line the cross 4 minutes. 4 minutes. Equal 30 into 4 equal to 120. 120 is calculated 2 hours time. 2 hours time. Time between the Arunachal Pradesh and Sudra, 2 hours difference time. The sun rises early morning in the Arunachal Pradesh and the Gujarat morning 7 a.m. Okay? In India, morning time 10 a.m. In India, morning time 10 a.m. In London, which time? The Indian time earlier was the 5:30 hours. Manaki London ki 5.5 gantalu teda untundi. Manam munduga untam kabatti London lo time ento avutundi ante manaki time 10 ayinappudu back ellipovali London ki. London ki 10 nunchi 9 8 7 6 5 4:30 morning 4:30 am. Morning 4:30 am London lo. In India 10 am. Okay, time calculated. We know what is latitudinal lines and longitudinal and IST, GMT and north side to south, north to side. How much the distance? 3,214 kilometers and west to east, Jammu Kashmir to Arunachal Pradesh, 2,933 kilometers. The IST line, Indian Standard Line, 82.5 degrees. Okay? The next one, fifth in ninth class, you know Alfred Wegener, the German geologist, the constitutional drift theory, the constitutional drift theory. Alfred Wegener. Here, 2,220 million years ago, only one landmass here. The old one, totally one landmass here. Next one, this is split to two parts. This is called Laurasia. Next, this is called the Indonesia. This is called the split into two parts. First one is the Eurasia and second one the Indo-Australia. The India is divided northern side. Here the one our continent Australia. This is way to southern side. Totally this one is the Angara land. Angara land has called the Eurasia and this is Gondwana. మొత్తము భూమి అంతా కూడా ప్రపంచం అంతా ఒకే భూమిగా ఉండేది. దాన్ని రెండు భాగాలుగా విభజించడం జరిగింది. దీని అంగారా భూమి అని, దీని గోండ్వానా భూమి అని. అంగారా భూమిని లురేషియా అని, గోండ్వానా అని, ఇండో ఆస్ట్రియా అని పిలవటం జరుగుతుంది. నెక్స్ట్ ఇక్కడ అంతా కూడా ఏముంది అంటే పాంజియా అండ్ పాంతర్సా. Okay, next we will go to our main topic. Relief features are physical divisions or relief divisions. The most important of the relief divisions are 6. First one, relief divisions. First one, the Himalayas. Indo-Gangetic Plain. The Indo-Gangetic Plain. Third one, the Peninsular Plateau. The Peninsular Plateau. Fourth one, the Coastal Plains. The Coastal Plains. Fifth one, the Desert. The Desert. Sixth one, the Islands. The Islands. The first main thing is the Indian divisions are, physical divisions are divided. So the main, first one is the Himalayas, second one the Indo-Gangetic Plains, third one Peninsular Plateau, fourth one the Coastal Plains, sixth one the Thar Desert, and sixth one the Islands. Okay, first we will discuss the Himalayas. Here, the eastern boundary is starting here. Okay, 2,400 kilometers. The Himalayas are formed. The Himalayas are formed eastern boundaries. It's 2,400 kilometers. It's divided into three ranges. First one the Himadri. Second one Himachal. Third one Shivalik. Okay, Himadri is called Greater Himalayas. Himadri is called Greater Himalayas. Second one, Himachal are called Lesser Himalayas. Third one, Shivalik. Shivaliks are called Outer Himalayas. First we will discuss the Himadri. Himadri is called Greater Himalayas. First point, Himadri is called Greater Himalayas. And its elevation 6,100 kilometers. Himadri is its elevation 6,100 kilometers. Here the great ranges, peaks, peaks are here. Mount Everest peak, Kanchenjunga, and K2 peaks. Here the main peaks, the whole number one Everest peak, 8,848 kilometers in Nepal. Next, Kanchenjunga. 8,598 kilometers in Sikkim. And K2, POK, Pakistan and Kashmir. This elevation is 8,611 kilometers. Okay? Himadri is called the Greater Himalayas. Its elevation is 6,100 kilometers. Here the most important peaks are here. The Mount Everest peak in Nepal, 8,848 kilometers. The second one is the Kanchenjunga in Sikkim, 8,598 kilometers. And K2, Pakistan and Kashmir, 8,611 kilometers. These are called the Himadri. The second one is Himachal. Second one, these lines are called Himadri, Greater Himalayas. This is Lesser Himalayas and this is Outer Himalayas. Okay? Second one, Himachal. Second one, Himachal. Second one, Himachal. Himachal. Same. These are called the Lesser Himalayas. Lesser Himalayas. Himadri are Lesser Himalayas. And Himachal elevation is 3,700 to 4,500 kilometers. 3,700 to 4,500 kilometers. Here the very attractive ranges are here. Attractive ranges are here. Kash, Kulu Manali. Next one is this is about the Himadri. Next we will discuss about the Himachal. Next, Himachal. Okay. Himachal are called Lesser Himalayas. Lesser Himalayas. The average elevation is 3,700 to 4,500 kilometers. Average elevation is 3,700 to 4,500 kilometers. Here, many hill stations here. Hill station. Mussoorie, Nainital, Raniket, Kulu, Kulu, Kangra, these hill stations. Mussoorie, Raniket. Raniket, Kulu. Okay, these are the important points of the Himachal. This is about the Himachal. Next one, we will discuss about the Shivalik. Next, Shivalik. Shivalik is called Outer Himalayas. Outer Himalayas. Outer Himalayas. Next, this average elevation is same. Average elevation is 900 to 1100 kilometers. 900 to 1100 kilometers. Here, dunes are low lying valleys. Are called dunes. For example, Dehradun, Patlidun, Potlidun. Dehradun in Uttarakhand, Patlidun and Potlidun. The Shivalik are the three ranges of the Himachal. First one the Himadri. Second one Himadri is also called the Greater Himalayas. Second one Himachal. Himachal are called Lesser Himalayas. Third one, Shivalik. Shivalik is Outer Himalayas. This average elevation is 3900 to 1100 kilometers. Here, many dunes are here. Dunes means low-lying valley. And for example, Dehradun, Patlidun and Potlidun. Okay? What is the importance of the Himalayas? Influence of the Himalayas. Importance of the Himalayas. Importance of Himalayas. Okay. First one, act as barriers. Second one, responsible for rains. Second one, responsible for rains. Third one, the originated of rains, for example, Indus, Ganga, Brahmaputra, the originated rains, the perennial river. రివర్సల్ పెర్నియల్ రివర్సల్ అంటే జీవనదులు పెర్నియల్ రివర్స్ మీన్స్ జీవనదులు ఎప్పటికీ ఎండిపోకుండా ఉండేటటువంటి ప్రవహించేటటువంటి నదులని జీవనదులు లేదా పెర్నియల్ రివర్స్ అంటారు హిమాలయాల్లో పుట్టినటువంటి రివర్స్ ఇండస్ సింధు గంగా బ్రహ్మపుత్ర సట్లెజ్ మాన్సూన్ రెయిన్స్ మాన్సూన్ రెయిన్స్ మాన్సూన్ రెయిన్స్ నెక్స్ట్ ప్రొటెక్టింగ్ అస్ ప్రొటెక్టింగ్ అస్ ప్రొటెక్టింగ్ ప్రొటెక్టింగ్ అస్ కోల్డ్ విండ్స్ కోల్డ్ విండ్స్ ప్రొటెక్టింగ్ అస్ కోల్డ్ విండ్స్ హియర్ ఆల్పైన్ ఫారెస్ట్ ఆల్పైన్ ఫారెస్ట్ ఆల్పైన్ ఫారెస్ట్ అండ్ హియర్ ద అట్రాక్టింగ్ ద టూరిజం ప్లేస్ అట్రాక్టింగ్ ద టూరిజం ప్లేసెస్ attracting the tourism places and here the famous the apples 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 Himalayas are not there our country is dry country protecting us the central asian winds are as protecting the Himalayas monsoon rains are and responsible for the rains originated the Himalayas rains rivers rivers next act as barriers china nunchi vastunna 20 shatrula daadi nunchi himalayalu mallini kaapaadutunnayi okay madhya asia nunchi vachete 20 chellati gaalu nunchi himalayalu mallini kaapaadutunnayi next rainfall sakalamlo nunchi maniki varsham kuravataniki నదులు ఎప్పుడూ ప్రవహించడానికి మనకి హిమాలయాల్లో పుట్టినటువంటి నదుల నుంచి వర్షాలు పడి సకాలంలో మనకి నదులు ప్రవహిస్తున్నాయి ఇక్కడ ఆల్పైన్ ఫారెస్ట్ నుంచి ఇండియా గవర్నమెంట్ కి ఇక్కడ ఫారెస్ట్ నుంచి వచ్చేటటువంటి అడవుల నుంచి లభించేటటువంటి కలప ముఖ్యమైనది నెక్స్ట్ టూరిజం ప్లేస్ అక్కడ హిమాలయాల్లో వచ్చేసరికి ముఖ్యమైనటువంటి టూరిజం ప్లేస్ అక్కడ వెళ్లి చూడటానికి విహార యాత్రకు వెళ్లి చూడటానికి ఉపయోగపడు నెక్స్ట్ మనం సిమ్లా యాపిల్స్ గురించి మనకు తెలుసు దీస్ ఆర్ కాల్డ్ ద ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఆఫ్ ద హిమాలయాస్ ఓకే దీస్ అబౌట్ ద ఫస్ట్ వన్ ఫస్ట్ మేజర్ డివిజన్ ఇస్ హిమాలయాస్ ఆర్ కంప్లీటెడ్ సెకండ్ వన్ ఇండో గ్యాంగ్టిక్ ప్లెయిన్స్ ఇండో గ్యాంగ్టిక్ ప్లెయిన్స్ second major division Indo-Gangetic plains okay Indo-Gangetic plains what is plains meaning plains are the due to the rivers plains are the boundary due to the rivers are brought to alluvium and deposited alluvium and deposited plains are the brought about rivers the main rivers is Indo and Gangetic here the Indo Gangetic rivers is divided to three parts first one western plains second one central plains third one eastern plains okay we will discuss about the western plains here western part Indo tens also called. Here, central part. Here, eastern part. The western part also called, first one the western part also called the Indo plains. Indo plains. Let us discuss about second major division, Indo-Gangetic Plains. What is meant by plains? Plains are formed by rivers. Rivers brought many alluvium and deposit. Here, this is called the Indo-Gangetic plains are divided three parts. The Indo-Gangetic plains are divided three parts. First one, western part. Second one, central part. Third one, eastern part. First one, western part. Here, west side. This is called western part. Western plain. Second one, this is. Central part. Third one here, eastern part. Okay, let us discuss about the western part. Western parts here are called the Indus River. Here the Indus River flow. Western part here, Indus River, and its tributaries. Its tributaries. What are the main tributaries of the Indus River? You know, Chandana brothers, Bomana brothers. You know, J.C. brothers. J.C. brothers means, J means Jhelum. Jhelum, Chenab, Bias, Ravi, Sutlej. Okay, here Indus River and the main tributaries are called the western part is the main important. J.C. brothers. J means Jhelum, C means China, B means Bias, R means Ravi and Sutlej. These are the important rivers in the western part. Okay, here the second one, the western part, the main, this is located in the Pakistan and the low part of the, less part of the Jammu Kashmir, here Punjab. Okay, here the main located Punjab and Haryana. Pakistan and less part in Punjab and Haryana. Okay, the second one, central part. This is Ganga River. Here, the Ganga River, the central plain, Ganga River flows. You know, 3G Now we are in 5G, 3G. Ganga River and its tributaries. Okay. 3G. 3G means first one Gomti. Next Ghaghar. And Gandak and Chambal, Ghaghar. Okay, these are the main important rivers: Ganga River, Gomti, Ghaghar, Gandak, and next one, Ganga Plains formed due to the Ganga River and its tributaries. Okay, Ganga River and its tributaries. What is the main tributaries of the Ganga River? 3G. Now we are in 5G. This is 3G. What is the 3G means? Gomti, Ghaghar, Gandak, and fourth one Yamuna River and Chambal River, Son. And Kasi. Son and Kasi. These are the main important tributaries of Ganga River. Here the most fertile rivers. Okay. Next, third one, the eastern part. Eastern plains are due to the plain Brahmaputra River and its tributaries. What are the main tributaries of the Brahmaputra? Dibang, Lohit, Dhansiri, Mansiri. These are the most important. Dibang and Lohit is the main important tributaries of the Brahmaputra River. Here the Arna in eastern the edge of the boundary, the Dibang Valley and the Dibang River is the most important river in the Brahmaputra tributaries. Okay. Next, here we discussed about the Himalayas and second one Indo-Gangetic plains. Himalayas are divided into three ranges: Himadri, this is called the Greater Himalayas; second one Himachal, Lesser Himalayas; third one Shivalik is called the Outer Himalayas. And second one, Indo-Gangetic plains. These plains are formed due to the rivers brought to alluvium and deposit. These are the divided into three parts. First one is the western part. Second one, central part. And third one, eastern part. First one, the western parts is formed due to the river Indus River. Indus River is the main tributaries. JC Brothers, Jhelum, Chenab, Ravi, Biaf and Satluj. And the second one, central part. Central part is called the formed due to the Ganga River. The 3G means Gomti, Ghaghar, Gandak, Yamuna, Chambal, Kosi, Son rivers. Okay? Here, third one is the eastern part. Eastern part is the formed due to the Brahmaputra rivers and tributaries. What are the main tributaries of Brahmaputra? Dibang and Lohit rivers. Okay, this is the Indo-Gangetic plains. Here the eastern part. Here the good transportation of the population. Most of the people live in plain areas. Where they like plain areas, మరి ఎక్కువ మంది ప్రజలు మైదాన ప్రాంతాల్లో నివసించడానికి ఇష్టపడుతుంటారు. ఎందుకు అంటే వ్యవసాయానికి ద మెయిన్ రీజన్ ఈస్ ద అగ్రికల్చర్. agriculture. And here flows the main tributaries, horizontal rivers are flow. Indus, Ganga and Brahmaputra cyclized rivers. These are called the perennial rivers. ఎప్పుడూ కూడా ఎండిపోనటువంటి జీవనదులు ప్రవహిస్తుంటాయి కాబట్టి మైదానాల్లో ఎక్కువగా జీవించడానికి ఇష్టపడుతుంటారు. ఈ నదుల్లో ఎక్కువగా జీవంతో కూడినటువంటి సెడిమెంటీస్ అంటే క్లే స్లిట్ అంటే ఎక్కువగా పెట్లే అంటే రసాయనాలు జీవ పదార్థాలతో కూడినటువంటి మట్టితో కూడినటువంటి ప్రాంతం కాబట్టి వ్యవసాయానికి అనుకూలంగా ఉంటుంది. హియర్ ద ట్రాన్స్పోర్ట్ ఈజ్ ఈజీ ప్లెయిన్ ప్లెయిన్ ఏరియాస్ రోడ్వేస్ ఎయిర్ లైన్స్ అండ్ రైల్వేస్ ద మోస్ట్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ రోడ్వేస్ అండ్ రైల్వేస్ అండ్ ఎయిర్ లైన్స్ ప్లెయిన్ ఏరియాలో అయితే ఈజీగా ఉంటుంది. అండ్ నెక్స్ట్ వన్ హియర్ ద అట్రాక్ట్ ద టూరిజం ప్లేసెస్ ఆల్సో టూరిజం కి కూడా ఎక్కువగా మైదాన ప్రాంతాలు ఎక్కువగా ఇష్టపడతా ఉంటారు. ఓకే థర్డ్ వన్ ద థర్డ్ మేజర్ డివిజన్ పెనిన్సులర్ ప్లాట్యూ. ఓకే పెనిన్సులర్ ప్లాట్యూ హియర్ హిమాలయాస్ అండ్ హియర్ ప్లేస్ దిస్ వన్ ఈస్ ద పెనిన్సులర్ ప్లాట్యూ. పెనిన్సులర్ ప్లాట్యూ హియర్ అరేబియన్ సీ ఓషన్ అండ్ ఇండియన్ ఓషన్ అండ్ బే ఆఫ్ బెంగాల్. This rest of place is called the triangle place. Three sides water and one side is land mass is called the peninsular plateau. Okay? Three sides of water, west side in Arabian Ocean and southern side is Indian Ocean. East side is Bay of Bengal. The only northern place is the occupied the Himalayas. This the rest of the place is called the triangle place. This is called the Peninsular Plateau. Peninsular Plateau is divided into two parts. Malwa Plateau and the Deccan Plateau. Here Malwa Plateau. First one Malwa. Second one, Deccan Plateau, here. Deccan Plateau. Deccan Plateau. Okay. Malwa Plateau and Deccan Plateau. Here, the north side here Aravalli ranges here Satpura ranges okay and here Malwa patches here east side the Aravalli ranges and the north side Satpura ranges and here Vindhya ranges. Next one here Deccan Plateau. Second one Deccan Plateau. Let us discuss about the third major division, Peninsular Plateau. Okay? Peninsular Plateau formed the Gondwana. in the world. Okay, Gondwana land is the oldest mass in the world. Peninsula Plateau is called the Indian Plate. Indian Plateau. Indian Plateau. Indian Plateau. Okay, next here the important volcanic here. Volcanic the expectations. And here main block sign here. Metallic and non-metallic minerals here. Metallic and non-metallic minerals here. This is not suitable for agriculture. Agriculture. Here, hot surface. Chota Nagpur is a heart of India. Heart of India. And here, Peninsula Plateau is divided into two parts. First one is the Malwa Plateau. And second one, Deccan Plateau. Here, Himalayas are an arch. Here the place, the rest of place is the Peninsula Plateau. Arabian Ocean, Indian Ocean, and Bay of Bengal. Okay? Bay of Bengal. Here, Malwa Plateau. Malwa Plateau. Divided into two parts. Malwa Plateau, southeast of the Gangetic Plain. Here, northeast side Aravali ranges, and south side Narmada River. And second one, Deccan Plateau. Here, the triangle shape, Deccan Plateau. Western Ghats, east side Eastern Ghats, north side here Satpur ranges, and southernmost tip of the India, Kanyakumari. Okay. Peninsula Plateau is called the Indian Plateau. This is formed the Gondwana land. This is oldest mass in world. And volcanics and blocks are in here. Okay. Metallic and non-metallic minerals are here. This is not suitable for the agriculture. Chota Nagpur is the heart of the India. Malwa Plateau here the south side, the northern and Deccan Plateau Bhumi. Deccan Plateau is western side is Western Ghats and eastern side is Eastern Ghats, and here India, top of southern side is the here Kanyakumari. This is the Peninsula Plateau. okay? This is about the Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats.
Located Chintapalli. Okay? Next one.
rainfalls. Next, less rainfalls. Okay, listen students. Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats difference between the first one the located in the western side in India, eastern side in India. Second one, the second point, parallel west line and parallel to east line. Next, here section from Maharashtra to Kerala, Odisha to Tamil Nadu. Continuous change is from this continuous the because the distracted by the rivers. Here Mahanadi, Mahanadi, here Godavari, Godavari, here Krishna, here Kaveri. Okay, distracted by the rivers. Here is the continuous the chain system. Next, higher than the Eastern Ghats, higher than the Western Ghats, lesser than the Western Ghats. Average height is the 2200 meters and average height is 900 meters. Hills are the most important hills in the Western Ghats. Pattern of hills. Here, Pala Hills, Sheshachalam, Palani Hills. Next, highest mountain in the Dodbetta. Here, Aramakonda in Vizag district, Chintapalli. Here, the heavy rainfall. Here, Eastern Ghats in the less Himalaya, less rainfalls. Next, today, I will give to just one small question to you. First one is the influence. What is the importance of the Himalayas question? Second one, the Indo-Gangetic Plains. Third one, the Peninsula Plateau. Tomorrow, I will ask you one question. What is difference between the Western Ghats and the Eastern Ghats? Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats, 4 marks question. Okay? Thank you. Thank you.